Next up, we're joined by an actor who shot to fame as Robin Hood. Do you remember him? Yeah, you do. It's the wonderful Jonas Armstrong. Woo! I've always been a really big fan of your name.
Jonas?
Yeah.
That's a great name.
It's Swedish. It originates in Sweden, I
think. It's great. Are you annoyed about the Jonas Brothers? Do you feel like they've sort of taken some of the credibility?
Yeah, perhaps it should have been included.
If you Google Jonas first, you should come up as me. Now it comes up as Zen.
Now those stupid brothers. We have a very weird fashion hygiene question to start off with. We read somewhere that you only wash your jeans every 8 months to preserve the beautiful blue colour of them. I mean, these are wonderful. Look at them.
Cheers.
To me, it's disgusting.
I don't think it's to do with the colour. It's when you buy untreated denim.
Wow, you really do have a theory.
No. If you wash it, then it distorts it, so you have to keep them rigid. So that's what I like to wear. So that's what I do.
But they don't smell.
You stick them in the freezer, stops them smelling.
Wow.
You smell fine.
Thank you very much.
Stick them in the freezer.
Now tomorrow night we can see you in Jimmy McGovern's award-winning drama, The Street.
That's right.
Now the story is pretty harrowing. So what's your character actually about?
My character's called Nick, and he's a soldier from Manchester. Goes away to fight in Afghanistan, and he's on a tour of duty. Comes across a situation where a bomb detonates and he gets a massive facial disfigurement to his face and comes back home, and it's about him readjusting into his family life and also his relationship with his girlfriend and reintegrating himself back into society, basically. And he's finding it pretty hard work.
It looks like quite an emotional part to play. Was it quite heavy?
It was quite heavy just because of the nature of the story. You know, this guy's kind of gone through a lot, and it's a pretty big ordeal which he's been through, and it's going to change his life from that moment on. So, yeah, I mean, it was pretty raw to do, definitely.
All right, now, Robin Hood was an action-packed show. There must have been a lot of training involved, and apparently you did a bit of a Wayne Rooney and broke your metatarsal bone?
Metatarsal, yeah. I was doing a fight with Richard Armitage, who plays Guy Gisborne.
Yeah.
And we were wrestling around, as you do, and I was thrown into the side of a building. I was supposed to go in with my back, but I hit it on the side, and my metatarsal bone broke, so I got sent home for 4 weeks.
You did Robin Hood for quite a few years. Was that the worst thing that ever happened?
Three years. Yeah, it was the worst thing that happened.
No, I think it could have been worse.
Yeah. I think overall that was the worst injury. But Keith Allen, he fell off a horse and part of his anatomy went black. We're not allowed to say which part. But people kind of ruptured ligaments, got black eyes, bruises. But again, it's all part and parcel of the job.
Yeah. Robin Hood. you are not playing Robin Hood. All that injury, it's all over.
It's all done.
That's part of your life that's done now.
That's part
it's over.
Of
there is a hugely Robin Hood movie though.
Yes.
With Russell Crowe playing Robin Hood. Mm. I don't know how I feel about that casting. How do you feel about it?
I was kind of, to be honest, when I found out it was happening, I was glad that my part in doing Robin Hood was finished, because I think Russell Crowe will be brilliant. I mean, Gladiator is one of my all-time great films, and he's going to be amazing, I think.
Okay. What's next for you? We heard about a film called Seeing Iris. You're cross-dressing in it, sure.
Yeah.
Nice.
I start to film that in 6 weeks in London with Noel Clarke, Hannah Spirit and an actress called Amy Pemberton, and I do apply like a roofer guy who becomes hypnotised and starts to like dressing as women, so be dressed.
So more makeup and more tights, a combination of the
bit
two.
More of that, yeah.
God, wow, well, you're so good at it.
Thank you, Jonas.
Thank you very much for coming in. The Street is on BBC One tomorrow at 9 p.m. For now, Jonas Armstrong.
Woo!
Right now.